good that somebody invented the iPad, right? Even though I look good for a 63-year-old man, I have a back problem. My arm is got hurt because from my mission trip, I was trying to get my luggage and I pulled a muscle. And even playing tennis with just one arm, you know, I still could play it. I lead a tennis group in our church, an American church in New Jersey, Houston, Texas. And I still enjoy that and play with passion. And I have my vision too. My vision has a problem because of my cataract, you know. And I just thank the Lord I'm still able to drive many hours. And I drove to Canada already and here in the East Coast and West Coast for hours. And just thank the Lord that by His grace, I can still do the things that God has called me to do. And for this iPad, you know, it's good that it's big letters. And I'm so happy that I have this. Praise the Lord. And turn to Ephesians chapter 5. Just bear with me, please. Just be patient. Very rare that I come here and I speak here in this beautiful church. I always thank the Lord for this church. Because with Brother Ed and Brother Gingon, and then Melvin came, and other families, we God used us to start this church, and I'm so happy just to be back here and just to see all of you. And the Lord is working. The Lord has a purpose for all of us. Ephesians chapter 5, 15 to 21. 15 to 21. Look carefully then how you walk, not as unwise, but as wise, making the best use of the time, because the days are evil. Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the will of the Lord is. And do not get drunk with wine, for that is debauchery, but be filled with the Spirit, addressing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody to the Lord with your heart, giving thanks always and for everything to God the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, submitting to one another out of reverence for Christ. Here St. Paul mentions some things that we need to pay attention. And Paul would echo this call to be aware that really the days are evil. And he would say that to Timothy, the young pastor, in 2 Timothy chapter 3, that the times are really getting worse. As our senior pastor at Calvary Community Church, where I'm one of their full-time missionaries, Pastor Steve Meeks, who said, the world is getting faster and faster, but it's also getting worse and worse. But the church is getting better and better. Because when there is darkness around us, the true church will keep on focusing on the Lord Jesus Christ. When there's darkness all over you, there's nothing and no one to go to but the Lord Jesus Christ. So the more you're getting closer to God. So it's getting worse, but you as a child of God, a true child of God, I'm not talking about other Christians who are faking it. But I'm talking about the true church. In the midst of chaos and disorder and problems that we are seeing and we're watching on TV, it's getting worse. But the church is getting better and better. And the key to that getting better, I'd like to present to you, which Paul would mention here. He said, do not get drunk with wine, for that is debauchery, but be filled with the Spirit. Do not get drunk with wine. And maybe many of us probably do not drink. I remember when I was an associate pastor here and working with Pastor Yuli, you know, then we went to South Brunswick, and we have a big Filipino community, and you know that, you know, our Filipinos love to eat, and so with that drinking, that lots of beer bottles with them, and they would invite me, Pastor Dan, come on, eat and drink, and I would have always an excuse, you know, I don't try to be spiritual, I just say that beer or wine is not good for my stomach, and that is really true. So I just eat the pulutan. I drink water, soda. The Lord is saying to us, do not drink, do not be drunk with wine. He's not just saying particularly about the wine. He is saying that there are many things that we are involved in, that we are indulging in it, and we are so busy with it that it's affecting our walk with the Lord. And if you remember the parable of the sower, the first soil is the hardened soil, then the next one, the thorny soil, then the stony soil, and the good soil. The thorny soil representing people are engrossed with so many activities, good activities, but it is also affecting their walk with the Lord. So the point that Paul is saying here is the same thing. Do not get drunk with anything that will leave you away from the Lord doing God's will. You have to learn to say no to the things that is putting you down. Things that even good things. And I have to remind my own son, you know, I'm just being practical here because I come and observe. They love to play games, electronic games, and I'm not good at that. I'd like to join them. But every time I remember when Jonathan was small with Joanne, I would play with the, you know, with Nintendo, and they always beat me. I'm not good in technology, even in just pushing button. I'm not good. They always beat me. I remember that fight, what's that fight, John? Tekken. Hi. Oh, they would kill me. They're very good. Even my own daughter, you know, very good. Because they're very good, coordinated, you know, the eyes, the mind coordinated. Mine is not coordinated. Especially now. I forget things now. And when my guys, you know, because I've been doing prison ministry for 15 years, 3 years here and going to 13 years in Texas. When my guys, when they get out, I always tell them, because I give them my telephone number. Because I don't only teach them for hours inside the prison, I follow them up when they get out. Because that is the key in helping these guys. So I use that Honda Pilot to pick them up. Because, you know, they have to find a job when they get out. And many of them, they have to find a house. Because many of them are separated from their families. And so they go to a halfway house. And I pick them up and bring them to church. Bring them to church. Then help them find jobs. Or help them find housing. And our house in Texas, in Houston, we use that. We open our house for these guys, for their families. When they come, the families, poor families who would like to visit their husbands or children in the prison, and they could not afford to stay in the hotel. So my wife and I, we let them sleep, the children and their mothers or their wives sleep in our house. Because our house is God's house. Then even my guys, I let them sleep until the warden told me I cannot do it anymore. Because